Hello.
In the previous video, I started to prepare for the repair of my milling machine. I showed how I checked the angle between this feed and the axis of rotation of the spindle. To do this, a faceplate was installed on the spindle. A workpiece made of Getinax was installed on the faceplate. A workpiece consisted of two identical pieces. They were glued together. A cutter was installed, and the workpieces were machined by moving along the Z axis. As a result, when I checked the straightness of the machined end, I found that it was very close to straight. This means that the Z axis is at an angle of 90 degrees to the axis of rotation of the spindle. Now, the second operation of checking the machine. The location of the X axis relative to the axis of rotation of the spindle. The same two blanks can be turned over to the other side. I note the first and second side. I install the working pieces on glue in order to exclude their deformation when clamping the fixing screws. I leave it alone so that the glue polymerizes. For additional control of the position of the cutter, a mechanical comparator is installed. Based on it, I can move the cutter to a very small size. This small movement can be done with a soft hammer. You can easily move 1 micron, another one. During this time, the glue became hard. Now you can tighten the screws. As far as possible, I clamp the wedges. Now, the cutter will move along the X axis. As a result, we will find out at what angle the X axis is located to the axis of rotation of the spindle. I make the first pass. I cut slowly. The chips are very thin. Cutter made of elbow. Very hard and sharp. I draw a line with a marker. I don't move the cutter closer. It stays in place. making the final path. The cutter, also in the same position, cuts off the chips. These can be seen from the marker line. It is only partially cut off. Finishing the final path. The machined face is parallel to the X-axis. I leveled this plate myself in my workshop by hand. Deviations on it are less than a micron. There is a video about it. The rulers are fixed with plasticine. It's simple and works well. The legs are finely polished. The center is 285 microns higher than the edges. The same can be determined by the gap between two identical edges, angle between X feet and rotation axis in this case. This is the result of simple calculations. The X feed in my machine is offset like this. I will take this information into account during the repair. I will cut off certain zones, less or more. Due to this, I will correct the position of the axis. In the next part, I will continue to determine the state of the feeds of my machine. I will make special devices for the repair of this machine. An ideal plane with submicron accuracy, with a gap in the middle, has been created here. This method will give an accurate surface. higher places are indicated. Correctly removing the metal, I will bring the feed axis to the correct position. I want to make a perfectly accurate machine at minimal cost. Continue in the next videos. I will show you everything in detail.
Thank you. Goodbye.